I'm Jordan Lulich, and this is the Lulich Corner, and today we sit down for another session with Jonathan Raymond from Seawinds Funeral Home. So first off, Jonathan, thank you for taking the time to come in and talk about, you know, really substantive, valuable things that are a huge benefit for our clients. I'm super excited for today's session because we're going to talk about something that people don't want to talk about. And before we get into it, I'd like for you to just introduce yourself and tell people a little bit about yourself and Seawinds Funeral Home.
Excellent. Well, my name is, Jordan said, is Jonathan Raymond. I've been a funeral director for a little over 30 years. Giving people an opportunity to pay tribute to their loved one is very important to me. It's a life mission to help people through the most deepest, darkest time in their life. And that's what we do at Seawinds Funeral Home.
You know, Jonathan, we do a lot of estate planning, as you know, and when you start thinking about estate planning, what you're thinking about something that most people, a lot of people fear is death. But that fear, I think people should set aside that because there is so much value when you think about estate planning, when you think about pre-planning from a funeral arrangement, because it's not about money. It's not about, you know, who's going to get what. It's about expressing your wishes.
Exactly. Exactly.
It all boils down to expressing your wishes. And so, you know, how does one go about, I guess, how, when, and why do some people need to choose to complete pre-arrangements and planning in advance? Like, how does that process work?
Before I answer that, if you allow me to, you use the word fear. And, you know, fear really is that of the unknown.
Yeah.
We're afraid of what we don't know.
Uncertainty.
Right? Dark water. We don't know what's in that dark water.
Yep.
Therefore, we have some fear or trepidation there. We've spoken in the past about meeting your funeral director or your prospective funeral director, seeing the facility that you're going to have your family in and the feeling that you get out of that. You know, pre-planning is very important. It takes the fear out of the unknown. No one passes this way but once, and no one, as easy as it is said, gets out alive, mm-hmm. right? Everybody knows death and taxes are the two most certain things in life and in death. Planning ahead removes you from that fear. Who's going to make the arrangements? What wishes are going to be followed? Are your needs and wants going to be met as a person to be remembered?
Yeah.
Who's going to pay for the funeral in today's financial atmosphere?
Sure.
You know, it's not easy to come up with money to do things regardless of what it is. So planning ahead gives you the opportunity to know that your wishes, needs, and wants are going to be fulfilled, knowing that you're sparing your family from that uncertainty. Oh my gosh, what are we going to do? What did they want to do?
And so from the estate planning perspective, I mean, that's, if you leave your loved ones with guessing what it is that you wanted, that's a horrible feeling to have. And then you get in a situation where someone thinks X, another family member thinks Y, and then they're arguing over what should happen.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of people say, "Oh, well, my family, they would never do that. They're a good family." They and they're not as aware as they should be that when you don't say what you want or express your wishes, then it leaves the door open to fighting or disagreements with the family. And so that just alone, that ability to sit down, the ability to go into a funeral home to think about what it is that you want, because it's a very, wouldn't you say it's extremely personal choosing your pre-arrangements, right? I mean, each person's going to have a different decision as far as what arrangements they want, right? I mean, do you guys do every single pre-arrangement the same?
No, it's done exactly as an at-need funeral would be done. Jordan, people are asked open-ended questions. How do you want to be remembered? What's important to you? What type of clothing would you like? What kind? Do you want an open casket? Do you want a closed casket? Do you want to be cremated? Do you want to be interred or buried in a cemetery or entombed in a mausoleum? Do you want to go to the veteran cemetery? Do you want to have military honors at your funeral?
Mm-hmm.
Not everybody wants the same thing. There's no cookie cutter anymore. It's all based on the needs and wants of the individuals that we're dealing with.
On how they want to be remembered.
Like you said, no one. The majority of people do not talk about what's going to happen after I die.
It's taboo.
Right. What's going to happen? And you mentioned it. And I can tell you from a personal experience, death brings out a lot of great emotions. happy celebrations,
yeah.
great memories, but also those ugly greed, jealousy,
yep.
Envy come out as well.
The best and the worst.
And can tear a family apart.
Yep.
Absolutely tear a family apart. And no one, I can't think of anybody that would consciously make a decision to tear their family apart when all they ever did in their life is to keep their family together.
Yeah. I mean, I am such an advocate of planning because I think at the root of planning, the result and the objective and the outcome that you're trying to achieve is you're preserving your family. For me, the two coincide together.
Mm-hmm. Peace. It brings peace to a unsettling, highly emotional event in someone's life. And, you know, being in the estate planning business, you know, and I do too from my experience in funeral service, that money's important to a lot of people, sometimes more important to them than themselves. If you don't make those provisions and give clear expectations in a legal binding document,
mm-hmm.
it can really upset something that could be very, not easy, but it can be much more peaceful, much more orchestrated, and much simpler for the family to follow your roadmap than to try to create their own. Like you said, everybody's got their own opinion.
One common question I get is from an estate planning perspective, and I think that this could be parlayed and kind of correlated to a pre-arrangement from the funeral side is, you know, I'm not sure that I'm going to stay here long-term. I might move up to my house up north. Do I need an estate plan? Do I need funeral pre-arrangements? So what would you say to that family who's contemplating a move in the next few years up north to them regarding, do they need pre-arrangements here or should they just wait to get up north?
Well, so you never know. We never know our time of demise. We never know when we're going to leave this earth. So if regardless of where you are in your life today, mm-hmm. having plans is better than having no plans at all. Right. Having the best plans that you can come up with, should you move up north, most funeral homes would accept a pre-arrangement from a prior funeral home.
They would. That's what I was...
Okay. Yeah. They may not be able to match the pricing because Florida is much more economical from funeral services. I came from up north.
Yeah.
Where I was just talking to you prior where a basic cremation up north is $4,000. Well, you can get a basic cremation down here for half of that.
Right.
Sometimes less depending on the level of service that you want. So you can always transfer or request a cancellation and a refund and then take your money and go back up north. But having no plans at all, since we don't know when the day comes for us, when our peg is going to be in that hole, so to speak, when our death occurs, everyone should have some type of plan. Even if it's written down and not funded, it's still a plan. If you fund it at Seawinds, you get the benefit of guaranteed pricing. As I said, if you move back up north, you have to find a new funeral home. We do have a network of funeral providers that run up and down the East Coast. Depending on where you are, we can just transfer your services there and you can fulfill them at the cost that you had them here. But if you choose a different funeral home outside of our network, those prices could vary and you'd be responsible for paying the balance of that.
So that's a clear benefit, you know, for working with Seawinds Funeral Group. What are some other benefits from a pre-arrangement perspective with working with Seawinds?
Well, first off, we care about everybody that we deal with. One thing that we do that not all funeral homes do is guarantee services and merchandise at the price you pay today. So if you paid $7,000 for your funeral today, the only thing that is not guaranteed are the costs of outside expenditures, such as the cemetery, clergy, newspaper, obituaries. But the services and merchandise that you selected, as long as nothing has changed from your desires, needs, and wants, we don't charge anything more than what your loved one paid during their pre-arrangements.
So inflation keeps going up, but you're eating that cost, essentially.
We are, essentially, okay. Yeah.
Yeah, that's an awesome benefit, especially what we've seen in the last 5 years.
Oh, Lord. Inflation is... And funeral service is not immune to inflation. Costs go up, casket prices go up, outer burial containers go up. But everybody's experienced that. And having that guarantee brings you peace of mind. And we all know that peace of mind is priceless.
Yeah.
Right. If we could go out and buy it for $59.99, everybody would be in
sold
line.
Out.
Yeah. Sold out.
Like toilet paper during COVID.
Absolutely.
So, you know, we talked a little bit about that emotional component of thinking about death and the intrinsic value of, you know, making that decision to plan your estate or plan your arrangements. And so say someone's, you know, has gotten there emotionally and they said that I'm ready to plan my and do my pre-arrangements. What advice would you give them? What advice would you give that person or that family who's ready to take that step in moving forward with pre-arrangements?
Well, you and I have spoken prior about selecting a funeral service provider or a funeral home or a funeral director, knowing that you have the ability to feel comfort, security, trust. You feel like you have a trusting relationship with someone. Yep. And you're going to get that value. I would always recommend that you can definitely call Seawinds Funeral Home. It's a place to start with no cost or obligation. You can ask all your questions. You will get all your answers. You will get a free cost quote so that you understand everything that goes into making funeral pre-arrangements. It gives you an opportunity to pay over time, which when a death occurs, you're expected to pay for that service that you're asking that funeral home to provide for you upfront at that moment.
Right.
Pre-arrangements gives you an opportunity to pay for it over time.
Okay.
So do you pay more? Yes, a little more. But that peace of mind is priceless, that everything is taken care of, that your needs and wants are satisfied, that you provided provisions, financial support, and made decisions that are going to benefit your family. When you don't address these things, we've spoken of it before, it can cause great unrest and stress in your family. Some people feel excluded from the arrangements. We invite all family members to come in. We, by law, deal with the legal next of kin, which would be a spouse if right. they're married, children, siblings, if or anybody else that's left right. in that hierarchy of order. Everybody at that moment has an opportunity to ask the question, to become comfortable with the answer, or to continue to peel that onion away until they are comfortable. And that's what we're here for, and we'll spend as much time as someone needs, like you would, in helping understand how someone's financial assets are going to be passed on after they pass away.
I'm such a huge advocate, Jonathan, of taking the time and actually putting in the thought, because what the reality is a lot of people probably know they need to do it, but most people just procrastinate. And that's the reality. So take the time, take the thought, have those conversations with your loved ones, plan your estate, plan your arrangements, because ultimately you're not doing it for you, you're doing it for your family.
That's right.
We've got to wrap it up today, but thank you for coming on. If people want to reach out to you, how can they find you and Seawinds Funeral
Home? They can find me at 735 South Fleming Street here in Sebastian. We have several funeral directors on staff there that can assist you and answer all your questions. Gives you an opportunity to be an informed consumer, and it's important to reach out to Seawinds Funeral Home and get all your answers that you need to make an informed decision.
I'm Jordan Lulich, and this is the Lulich Corner. We'll see you next time. Thank you.